Iron, third lecture. Dear students, in previous lecture we have done absorption, transportation, storage and utilization of iron, the factors which increases the absorption of iron in intestine, as well as the factors which decrease the absorption of iron in intestine, as well as we also learned about storage proteins, transferrin, transport proteins, how the iron transported in plasma and how it delivered in erythroid cells. In today's lecture, we're going to discuss loss of iron from the body, the diseases, certain diseases which associated with significant loss of blood, disorders of iron metabolisms, included iron deficiency anemia, iron overload, relevant to the total iron binding capacity. Let's start our topic, loss of iron from the body. Iron, one way element, body use iron very efficiently and very little iron is lost from body of normal males. About 0.5 to 1 milligrams iron lost per day through small intestine. Practically no iron is present in urine because iron in plasma is tightly bound with protein called transferrin. With being a protein, is normally not filtered by the renal glomeruli. In condition of proteinuria, iron is also secreted in urine. In nephrosis, iron loss up to 1.5 milligrams daily through urine. Excessive sweating, iron loss up to 2 to 3 milligrams per day. In addition to the above losses, women lost iron through menstruation. Which on average amount of 30 ml of blood during period may be as high as 80 ml of blood has about 40 milligrams iron. Daily iron loss in women of childbearing age amount 1.5 to 2 milligrams. Women also lost iron during pregnancy and during after birth of child, postpartum hemorrhage. Breakdown of RBCs normally result in a liberation of about 25 milligram iron every day, but it is reused for synthesis of new hemoglobin. Human body can lose maximum of 4 mg iron per day in absence of bleeding. Excessive loss seen in menstrual blood in women and in men from gastrointestinal bleeding included peptic ulcer, in diverticulosis or in malignancy. Certain diseases which associated with the significant loss of blood includes peptic ulcer, hemorrhoids, menorrhagia, which we called excessive menstruation, hookworm infection, especially in rural areas where sanitation is poor, as well as aspirin intake. Now, the disorders of iron metabolism. Iron deficiency and iron overload are the major disorders of iron metabolism. Iron deficiency. A deficiency of iron causes a reduction in the rate of hemoglobin synthesis and erythropoiesis and can result iron deficiency anemia. Iron deficiency anemia is the commonest of all single nutrient deficiencies. The main cause are deficient intake, deficient in dietary intake, as well as reduced bioavailability of iron. Iron deficiency anemia causes a low hemoglobin, resulting in hypochromic microcytic anemia, in which the size of RBCs are much smaller than normal. And has a reduced hemoglobin content, less than 12 grams per deciliter. RBCs are smaller in size and has less hemoglobin, as well as less mean corpuscular volume and less mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration. RBCs count become low, but hemoglobin levels still lower. Plasma iron concentration is usually less than 80 microgram per deciliter, associated with a total iron binding capacity of more than 400 micrograms per deciliter. Total iron binding capacity. Before we're going to discuss about the total iron binding capacity, we should know the biochemical investigation which have done for diagnosing the iron deficiency. These biochemical investigation which have done for diagnosing iron deficiency include serum iron, total iron binding capacity, serum ferritin level. To detect the early iron deficiency is to examine the bone marrow stain to detect the presence or absence of storage iron. Total iron binding capacity. The transferrin, as we already know, the transferrin molecule bind free iron and transport it into the blood. Total iron binding capacity measures the blood's capacity to bind iron with transferrin. Total iron binding capacity measures the blood's capacity to bind iron with transferrin. It is calculated by adding serum iron and unsaturated iron binding capacity, mostly used along with a serum iron test to evaluate people suspected to having either iron deficiency anemia or iron overload. Total iron binding capacity increase in iron deficiency anemia and decrease in infections. It also decrease in hemochromatosis, decrease in thalassemia, as well as a decrease in pernicious anemia or vitamin B12 deficiency. Now the clinical features of iron deficiency anemia, that includes weakness, fatigue, dizziness, palpitation. Non-specific symptoms are nausea, anorexia, constipation, and menstrual irregularities. Some individuals also develop pica, a craving of unnatural articles of food, such as eating clay or chalk. In addition to symptoms which are common to all anemias, as pale appearance, a breathlessness, or on minor excretion, patient shows some characteristic features that includes a derangement of epithelial surface, abnormal nail growth, spoon-shaped nails, fissures around the corner of mouth, glossitis, and localized thickening of mucus lining of the esophagus, causing dysphagia. Effect of iron deficiency anemia in child's includes irreversible impairment of child's learning ability, impairment of work capacity in adults, also occur low enzyme activity, and growth becomes retarded. Oral iron supplementation is the treatment of choice in iron deficiency anemia. Now, iron overload. Hemosiderosis and hemochromatosis, as well as iron poisoning, are conditions associated with iron overload. Hemochromatosis. Hemosiderosis. Hemosiderosis is a clinical condition used to employ an increased iron storage as hemosiderin without associated with any tissue injury. No tissue injury seen in hemosiderosis. Hemosiderosis actually is an initial stage of iron overload. Hemosiderosis commonly seen in some African countries where cooking is done in iron utensils that increase dietary iron intake. Now, hemochromatosis. Hemochromatosis is a clinical condition in which excessive deposits of iron in the form of hemosiderin are present in tissues, which develop injury to involve organs. Iron going to be deposited in liver, pancreas, heart, adrenal gland, testes, ovaries, pituitary gland, and kidney. Patients may develop hepatic, pancreatic, and cardiac insufficiency and hypogonadism associated with impotency in males. In hemochromatosis, skin becomes bronze due to accumulation of iron and melanin. Bronze skins, along with diabetes mellitus, give this disease another name, bronze diabetes. Cause of hemochromatosis may be genetic, primary, or may be acquired secondary. Primary or genetic hemochromatosis is a hereditary disorder due to an unregulated increase in the intestinal absorption of iron from normal diet. Patient with hemochromatosis absorbed about 4 mg of iron per day rather than 1 mg from gastrointestinal tract. Iron is deposited as hemosiderin in liver, pancreas, heart, and other organs. After accumulating for years, the excessive amount of intracellular iron leads to tissue injury and ultimately causes organ failure. At this stage, the amount of storage iron may exceed 20 grams rather than normal 3 to 4 grams. Secondary or acquired hemochromatosis. The main cause of acquired hemochromatosis are chronic overload, which occur when the diet contains excessive absorbable iron, for example, acid containing food cooked in iron pots. Parenteral administration of iron or chronic blood transfusion, for example, blood disorders like thalassemia, as well as alcohol abuse due to an ethanol-induced increase in iron absorption, they lead to acquired hemochromatosis. Now, the clinical symptoms of hemochromatosis are related to the involved organ systems. That includes liver leads to a cirrhosis, pancreas leads to a fibrotic damage to pancreas with diabetes mellitus, skin becomes bronze, pigmented bronze diabetes, endocrinology leading to endocrine disorders leading to hypothyroidism, testicular atrophy, ovarian atrophy, joints lead to arthritis, heart leading to arrhythmias and heart failure. That's all about iron metabolism.